This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the side splitter theorem. I'll explain what the theorem is about, and then I'll do a proof for it. And then I want to go on and talk about the converse to the theorem. So the side splitter theorem says that if a line parallel to one side of a triangle intersects the other sides, then it divides those sides into proportional segments. So here's what this means. If I've got a triangle, like triangle ABC, and I draw a line parallel to side BC, we'll call that line DE, so that it intersects the other two sides, then this theorem says that it's going to divide those sides into proportional segments. So for this specific triangle, it would mean that line segment AD over line segment DB would be the same thing, would be equal to line segment AE over line segment EC. In other words, the two fractions that I've just made would be proportional to each other. So here's how we can prove this. I've got two parallel lines, DE and BC, and the two sides of the triangle that DE intersects could be thought of as transversals that are cut by those two parallel lines. So we know that corresponding angles along that transversal, or each of those transversals, would be congruent angles. So angle B would have to be congruent with its corresponding angle ADE. And in the same way, angle C would be congruent with its corresponding angle AED. The next thing I'm going to do is draw a line from point D parallel to side AC so that it intersects side BC. I'll say that it intersects it at point F. So now I've got another pair of parallel lines, DF and AC, and I can think of side BC as a transversal, which is cut by those parallel lines. So that means that, once again, corresponding angles along that transversal would be congruent. So angle C would be congruent with its corresponding angle DFB. But we also know that angle C is congruent with angle AED. That means angle DFB must be congruent with angle AED. Now let's look at triangle ADE and angle DBE. We can see that these are similar triangles because they've got two pairs of corresponding angles that are congruent to each other. So we've got angle-angle similarity. Now, if these two triangles are similar to each other, then their sides are proportional. That would mean that side AD over its corresponding side, DB, would have the same proportion, it would be the same fraction as side AE over its corresponding side, DF. Now realize that DF is congruent with EC, because these are opposite sides of a parallelogram. So I can take that proportion I've just written, and instead of using DF, I can use EC, since they're congruent. And now what I've got is line segment AD over line segment DB equals line segment AE over line segment EC. In other words, the ratios are the same, and that's exactly the same thing that I started out with. So that's my proof of this theorem. To summarize the theorem one more time, if I've got a triangle and I've drawn a line parallel to one side of the triangle so that it intersects the other two sides, then it's going to divide those other two sides into proportional segments. Okay, here's the converse to the theorem. The converse says this. What it's doing is it's just turning the theorem around. It says, If a line divides two sides of a triangle into proportional segments, then the line is parallel to the third side. So once again, I've got triangle ABC, and I've drawn line DE through two of the sides, through AB and AC. And I know that it's divided those two sides into proportional segments. So line segment AD over line segment DB equals line segment AE over line segment EC. Since that's the case, this theorem, the converse of the side splitter theorem, says that line DE is parallel to side BC. Okay, so that's the side splitter theorem and its converse. Take care. I'll see you next time.